hello there. Time for some more Forza Horizon, I guess. And I'm gonna do, I don't know, I guess I will continue with the club circuit. Try my hand at it a little bit more. Did I choose the right one? Let's look, if I'm still number one, wait, I'm in a different car by now. My dirt, still number one, pretty sweet. Let's try something I'm slightly, let's try with this one, I'm way behind. Let's try the one I like actually. Let's first of all look at the leaderboards. What popped up? Lotus 211, but Maserati is pretty high up top as well. I like Maserati, let's try Maserati first. Doesn't work out, we're gonna go with something else. Well, not by something else, I obviously mean Lotus 211, because that is the stuff that's on top. Did make mistake in the first corner and the second corner, but otherwise it was fairly alright. Let's put on a good lap, the time satisfied with it, and go and look at picking up a different ghost. I believe the top time was 34.7. I'll get anywhere close. But let's see where I do get. Yeah, 4 seconds slower is a lot. Might make sense to be in second gear in this corner. It also makes sense to put up traction control. Oh crap. Not good. It's also pretty bad. Slow. not so sure what the past tense of break would be in this case. Heartbreaking. Is it broke? It sounds wrong. Maybe slightly faster than my previous laps. I think, like, if the top two Lotuses were in 34, I think the Maserati is 35. So still quite a bit to go. Braking, now just lifting, could actually have a bit more power on, I think. I very much doubt that going behind the tree there is the best way to take this corner. Slowest way, but that is we'll see. It always costs time. Definitely, if I want to win, I will definitely take the first corner faster. All right, you know what? Let's finish this up. Actually. Yeah, let's finish this up and then let's try to do it between traction control. Look at how I'm doing there. 61. Alright, 61. Oh wow, no ABS and no traction. On Lotus 211, I always thought it was a very tricky car to drive, the Lotus. Alright, let's try this again. Oh wait, no. Let's try this again with the same car. Actually, let's where is the garage? Let's first of all look at the garage.
Dude, how's things?
Great. Not auto upgrade. That was an error. I didn't mean that upgrade, custom upgrade. Alright, so front splitter, should we have it? Did I feel like we should have it? Honestly, no. Rear one? Maybe, but let's stick with the way it is for now. Bigger tires? I think actually, yes. And what's important here? This one. I think we can actually go with and better brakes here. Yeah. See? For my festival circuit hypercar, I had rather precise setup. Oh, I remember, I used to publish my setup. I used to look up my setup and publish it in my YouTube videos. I forgot to do that for... I hope I remember it. I mean, I still didn't touch my transit. So I can essentially look through the upgrades and upload it to YouTube. Right, so bigger wheel, traction control, and then later maybe, if things aren't work out, I might... Right, with the spoilers later. Let's go. Also, still, I would be interesting. I don't think I ever done any entries on the leaderboards. Or anything. It definitely felt like there might be a need for traction, so let's try it with this one. Alright. I think that's the same guy. Same guy was one of my ghosts for transit one. I think that's the result of bigger wheels, but we will see. Not sure yet of their usefulness or lack of thereof. A bit less sharp entrance into the last corner. Not sure if that's a result of. Not sure if the entry is a rather poor entry in that corner is a result of. He definitely rotates better, and he also has a spoiler, the proper spoiler there. Bit of a spin there, so I should be able to take him, but then again it was only 51. It also means that it's not necessarily the top level guys, so that's kind of spoiler there. I think I'd rather have this without. I'd rather have it without the bigger rims. This messy corner there, a bit messy corner here. But I get closer to him than before, that's good. Is it my improvement in the world time? I'm not sure, I don't remember what the world time was. Here I think it's beneficial. Yeah, the Astros are definitely seems beneficial. A bit break here. Should have went slightly different about it. Should have, I think, broke later and taken more shallow approach. I stopped this one a little bit. And yeah, definitely understeering in the last corner. Alright, so. Let's do one last lap. After it, let's turn the traction control off. Give us an idea if that understeer is caused by traction control or the rims. Yeah, definitely lifting there gives better exit than whatever he's doing. Messed up here, broke too much, I think. Even though my exit was faster overall last time to him. here definitely shallower entrance. I actually do want to try again another lap, because I think part of the reason I'm behind him is my own, although definitely with that kind of success I'm not gonna be getting. Yeah, here it's I'm still faster, but I sort of made a bit of an error there. Another here. Yeah, a bit of a mess of a lap. Again, I can do better, so let's continue until I feel like it. I can't. I mean, obviously can go better, but you know, I'm looking to cut 3 seconds, so I'm looking for something big. Bit lift here, but a bit lift here offers you a tighter corner, and no, not right now. But it offers you a tighter corner, and hence. Tighter corner and more traction. That's what's important. Tighter corner is not as important. Offers you more traction, so you get better acceleration for this corner. This one is tricky because it's like I feel like you have to cut grass, so you have to be really careful to keep traction on the exit there. Yeah, a bit slow through here, lifted too late here, so wasn't as good of a exit. Fine, almost fine. Sort of had to correct there and hence couldn't avoid the tree. Allowed for a bit more slip now and hence avoided the tree. Just lift here and push through. I think I catch up some time to him, but that might not be possible to just lift. Maybe you need to brake. It would depend on whether you can lift there or not. Would depend on the previous corner. So yeah, also a bit of a not so good, but still better than him. Bit of a brake here. Yeah, I think that was best, but I cut up here. I was sort of like took a corner which exit put me on grass. Can do better, can beat this guy. So this was a bit, yeah, this was horrible. Right, doesn't matter to me. Let's restart it now. I mean, I know I can do better here, but at this point I should restart it and... Traction off. I forgot to switch gears, but first lap is better anyway. I wanna see the first corners, which I would only see at speed. I wanna see the last corner, which I will see now. Is this better here without traction? It might be. Felt a bit more nimble here. I'm not sure either yet. Here is it better? Attraction, not sure either yet. It was sort of poor previous corner, so it was like sort of slow, and it still wasn't particularly pointy. So, no, definitely first corner is the result of the rims being what they are, not the traction. Second corner, is it better with that traction? I think so, this corner. Not sure, again a little sloppy this corner. Maybe better without traction. I don't know, it feels like bigger wheels without traction. Somewhere it's better. than smaller ones. I don't know. I'm not gonna be getting VR, WR with this one. Lift, a bit sleep, but sleep of the wheels, but this is good. This was rotation sleep, not too much loss of grip, not too much loss of accelerative power. This one was, I think it was a bit of a sloppy corner, but I'm still ahead. This one was, I think, also a bit of a sloppy corner. This one, decent, I think. Gonna beat the guy. Yes, finish. I still need over 2 seconds just to beat all the other Maseratis, but I cut half a second on him. I will now go and try this with the Diff could also be experimented with, I guess. Garage first, that's right.
Yo, bud,
upgrades. I'm gonna keep the wheels on for now. I'm gonna see how much I can actually get with the spoilers, because spoilers are do matter hugely. I mean, this really provide big difference to how the car handles, and the rim sizes, I think I correctly call them tire sizes, the rim sizes aren't they refine entrance and exits of the corner, all that stuff, but I never gained a significant amount of time while experimenting with them, so I will probably see now if I need to switch to Lotus or not. Bad top 30, that's a result that I find acceptable for now. Obviously, I think top 10 is what I expect of myself on most combinations, but I do struggle with some cars and I do struggle with some trucks. I think trucks, though, aren't really struggle. Trucks just take time to learn them.
You've missed the checkpoint.
I was watching something else, I didn't realize. Cuba Gooding Jr. doing some breakdance. I really need to feel super good about this car to continue this car. Ghost. I wonder if no ghost is a bug or all hoaxers. but I don't feel like there is as much of a loss of speed in that particular corner while going off track as there is in other cars I tested. Sliding for it to be unsettled, the car can just be unsettled and it can go through several corners. That's sort of like a good, but then I sort of like did too much grass there. Did too much grass cup up. Crank? What was that? Oh, it's a... It's a clump. Hope it's not irreversibly effed. There goes and clumping itself. I would have such an easier time here if I was doing what the cool kids are doing. Like club sport or whatever, the Fanatec wheels would be make me hear a lot more. It would make it a lot easier to hold on a second. Some more suffering is in order. One day it will still simply stop working and then I don't know how I'm gonna play with this wheel. Because it's gonna break soon. I can feel that. Alright, so I fixed it a little bit. Let's ease up a little bit and then slide it into the table. So it's sort of steel. Because for some reason when it's under the table it doesn't clamp at all at that angle. I have to squeeze it before I slide it on the table. There we go. There we go. It's fine when I'm going sort of small adjustments, but when I go to the, you know, some kind of table. What am I talking about? When I go to a sharp corner and I need to make a lot of wheel movements, it gets effed. I think maybe if I'm gonna get a giant, what they called, not a bolt, but what you bolt things to. Not the washer. The washer is just a piece of circular, like a metal donut. The nut, it's called the nut. You need to get some kind of nut. Couple, right? And just bolt it down on the inside here into the free line, because it's all plastic. The bolt essentially goes into plastic instead of in a nut. Actually, no. I don't know why. No, there is, I can see it, it's metal. It's embedded in plastic, but it's metal. It's pretty weird. I wonder if I can screw it down into like just table, like a wooden table, just screw it into it. Forget doing anything else. Play Horizon all the time. I don't really know why the metal nut is not locking. It's no goddamn sense to me. Oh, wait a minute. It's just not even the same size anymore. I can see it wobble inside this this nut. It doesn't hold the bolt at all. It's a mystery it was holding before. Right, so then I would need something to maybe slide in there. This would be ridiculous. This is a big piece of metal, and as I use it, it's gonna fall down and it's gonna break my legs if I use it here. So it's not like I'm gonna be paying attention to it. It'll be intense. Legs. Hook it up. There we go. Hooked it up. It holds for now. It's gonna just break off the plastic things because it's like such a acute angle of leverage.
Not sure if that's the risk I wanna take. Cause this is gonna hurt. Holding it down now. It acts as a counterweight, but you can imagine how high it is to act as a counterweight.
Thank you. brake a bit too much. Just the car slowed down a bit more. Shit. And here obviously not enough.
Get to your next wristband faster by driving clean and avoiding collisions.
Play plus. pressed X on that. Yeah, not so good time. So I'll have like ABS and traction for some reason I don't understand. I don't think it really improves much on this car, but the Phantom is all dynamo.
Dude, what's up?
Characters with levels, filter, everything. What is a supercar? Yes, supercars. Regular supercars, not classic. Let's hope that. Again, it is with levels. Check out what upgrades I would want in theory on this car. I said before, when I was doing it, it was quite a tricky car to drive. Maybe I improved my style change, whatever. I don't know. I actually sort of. I sort of felt. Like I was trying the cars and I had a certain prayer. Expectations that I already formed of how they can behave and sort of some of the cars actually.
это good. There is nothing happening, you probably didn't even see anything, but the car was brakes and then it moves on and like you can see he sees that he goes over so he goes responsible at the same time, it can be not responsive. I guess the same goes for any car in the game. Because of the rest of the world.
cut anyway, so...